अन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मीति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषामहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विजाति पूर्वं यदागच्छप्रणोति तस्मै ब्रह्मदेवमात्मवृत्तिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव अन्नमत्तो निश्चितामतिः। ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चय इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज ज्ञान एंड कर्म आर अपोज टू ईच अदर। कर्म एंड उपासना आर नीडेड फॉर चित्त शुद्धि। कर्म इज नीडेड सो दैट दी पाप इज टेकन अवे एंड चांचल्य गोज अवे बाय उपासना। वंस दिस टेक्स प्लेस, चित्त शुद्धि टेक्स प्लेस, देन ज्ञानोत्पत्ति इज पॉसिबल एंड देयर बाय मोक्ष। सो देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कर्म एंड उपासना बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन एंड देयर इज नो नेसेसिटी ऑफ कर्म एंड उपासना बिकॉज देयर इज नो बेनिफिट दैट यू डिराइव फ्रॉम कर्म एंड उपासना आफ्टर चित्त शुद्धि इज अटेन्ड। ज्ञानी अपि अंतकरण चांचल निवृत्ते उपासनम अनुष्ठेयम् इति आक्षेपः तत्समाधानञ्च। सो अर्लियर वी सॉ दैट मुमुक्षु शुड प्रैक्टिस दिस कर्म एंड उपासना। सो जीवन मुक्त आनंदस्य एंड ज्ञान रक्षण आल्सो, फॉर ज्ञान रक्षण इट इज नीडेड। सो दैट इज अनदर पॉइंट दैट इज ब्रॉट अप बाय द पूर्व पक्षी। सो दैट इज बीइंग लुक्ड इनटू एंड ज्ञानिना अपि even a jnani should practice this upasana and karma. Why? Because antakrana chanchalya nivrut. Karma, okay, let's compromise on karma, say that karma is not needed but upasana is needed because chitta has to be achanchala for nishtha to be there. Therefore upasana has to be practiced by jnani. यदि अत्र एवं आशंकेत रागद्वेषादय अंतकरणस्य सहजा धर्मः। यावत् काल पर्यन्तं अंतकरणमस्ति तावत् काल पर्यन्तं रागद्वेषादय ज्ञानिनोपि सर्वथा न नश्येयुः। रागद्वेष विल बी देयर एज लॉन्ग एज अंतकरण इज देयर। ज्ञानीज अंतकरण इज गोइंग टू बी देयर एज लॉन्ग एज प्रारब्ध इज देयर, शरीर इज देयर। सो ड्यू टू दैट शरीर बीइंग देयर until videha mukti there will be raga dvesha because they are the very nature of antakarana to give place to the vasanas to manifest as raga dvesha. Sorry. So yavat kala paryantam antakaranam asti tavat kala paryantam raga dvesha adya jnanina api sarvata nanashyeyu, they will be there. And if they are there ताभ्याम रागद्वेषाभ्याम ज्ञानिनापि अंतःकरणं चांचल्यं आपद्येत। देन दीज रागद्वेषास विल फोर्स दी ज्ञानी टू गो आउटवर्ड एंड इंडल्ज, और इफ नॉट गो आउटवर्ड एंड इंडल्ज देन इवन एज अ सन्यासी सिटिंग वेर एवर यू आर, सन्यासी और नॉन सन्यासी, इन दी अंतःकरण यू विल बी एंटरटेनिंग रागद्वेषास, देयर बाय देयर विल बी मनोराज्य। The very basis for which you are into the sannyasa ashrama or you have withdrawn from the society, that very basis you are not meeting because ragadveshas are keeping the mind busy. You cannot focus on brahmatma, you cannot have nishtha in brahmatma. This is the objection. Tasma chanchalya nivrutte jnanina api upasanam avashyam anushteyam. So the solution is to keep the antakarana achanchala by practicing upasana as prescribed in the shastras. Yadyapi antakarana chanchalyena jnaninah videha mokshasya kachidapi hanirnasti tathapi chanchale antakarane swarupananda bhanam nasyat. So fact is that Purvapakshi is saying that the fact is, even if the antakarana chanchala, becoming chanchala, it won't take away the videha mukti of the jnani. But you are talking about jivan mukti, that is your moksha really. So has he attained jivan mukti rupa moksha? No, why? Because ananda is lacking. Jivan mukti ananda is not possible. If he indulges in ragadvesha, then antakarana cannot have ananda vritti. The Swarupa Ananda Vritti won't take place because it is your own explanation. Purvapakshi says it is your own explanation. You, the Siddhanti, has always been saying, even in this Taittiriya, Ananda Mimamsa, you have said the explanation of the Priya Moda Pramoda, all this you explain by saying that Ananda is your own Swarupa Ananda. And what is blocking it? Or what makes it attain is the status of the antakarana. Therefore, the vritti is continuing, ragadvesha vritti is continuing. There won't be swarupananda in that kind of a chanchal antakarana. Tatascha antakarana chanchalyam jivan mukter virodhi. Therefore, this chanchalya is opposed to the jivan mukti. So, from jivan mukti ananda, he has landed on jivan mukti. तस्मा जीवन मुक्त्यानंद सिद्धये अंतकरणस्य चांचल्य निवृत्त्यर्थम उपासनम ज्ञानिनापि अनुष्ठेयमेव इति. Thereby, what he has proposed is upasana should be practiced by jnani. Tanna sangacchate, says the Siddhanti. That is not a valid objection. Why? यद्यपि दृढ़बोधः यस्य अंतकरणे अस्ति तस्य समाधि विक्षेपा विक्षेपौ उभौ अपि तुल्यौ एव इति तेन विदुषा अंतकरण नैश्चल्य संपादनार्थम न कोऽपि प्रयत्न कर्तव्यः. सो दृढ़बोध, डज ही हैव दृढ़बोध और नॉट, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन फॉर टैगिंग दिस ज्ञानी एज जीवन मुक्ता और नॉट. वंस द ज्ञान इज मनन सिद्ध संशय रहिता, दैट इज सफिशियंट टू कॉल दैट पर्सन एज अ जीवन मुक्त. ही हैज जीवन मुक्ति. विदेह मुक्ति ही डज नॉट हैव, दैट पूर्वपक्षी एंड सिद्धांती एग्री, देर इज नो डिबेट देर. बट जीवन मुक्ति बाय डेफिनेशन सेज द सिद्धांती इज व्हेन देर इज संशय रहित ज्ञान. सो यद्यपि दृढ़बोधः यस्य अंतकरणस्ति तस्य समाधि विक्षेपौ उभौ अपि तुल्यौ एव इति. सो वेदर ही हैज समाधि और विक्षेप, वेदर ही इज रिजॉल्विंग द अंतकरण इन द ब्रह्मात्मा विच इज हिज ओन स्वरूप, और ही लुक्स एट द वर्ल्ड विच इज विक्षेप, बोथ आर एट अ सिमिलर level, at the same level rather. Tena vidusha antakkarana naishchalya sampadanartham na kopi prayatna kartavya. Why? Because wherever the antakkarana goes, his focus is on the lakshya. Even in the vikshepa, when he looks at prapancha, yatra yatra mano yati tatra tatra samadayaha. So this samadhi, or if you look at vikshepa also, even in vikshepa, he is finally going to land on the अधिष्ठान स्वरूप, अधिष्ठान ब्रह्म विच इज ओन स्वरूप. सो तुल्य, देर इज नो डिफरेंस देर. देर बाय अंतकरण नैश्चल्य संपादनार्थम टू ब्रिंग अबाउट दिस अचंचलत्वम ही डज नॉट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग. स्टिल तथापि विदुष प्रवृत्ति निवृत्ति प्रारब्धाधीने। However, this yatra yatra manoyati tatra tatra samadaya, that statement is not applicable to all jnanis. Siddhanti accepts it. Not all jnanis are same. Jnana is same. In jnana also, samshaya sahita, samshaya rahita. There is a difference. And samshaya sahita jnana is not really considered as jnana. It is paroksha jnana. Aparoksha jnana is samshaya rahita jnana. This samshaya rahita jnani, he is a jnani no matter what, but there is a gradation in this kind of a jnani. That gradation is dependent on the prarabdha, because prarabdha is not same for everyone. It can be different and it is mostly different. There is some overlap whereby people come together. Similarly, jnanis may also come together or they may play a similar role. So prarabdha may be similar, it is not same. So prarabdhadhine pravrutti nivrutti. Whether the jnani continues in his own ashrama, pre-jnana, or takes to sannyasa like Yajnavalkya after jnana. So whether one becomes a vidvat sannyasi, takes vidvat sannyasa or does not take to vidvat sannyasa is also dependent on prarabdha. Prabala prarabdha is there, one cannot leave home. Even after taking sannyasa, the samsara will keep on haunting the person, because person is in the antakarana and sharira is associated with these prarabdha, therefore they will continue to haunt that person. He himself withdraws, but then for the onlooker, all these prarabdhas are affecting the jnani. Jnani is not affected really. Tathapi vidusha pravrutti nivritti prarabdha dine. Whether he indulges based on these ragadveshas, which are prarabdha kruta. Ragadveshas also coming up due to many reasons. One entertains them and thinks about it and brings it to the forefront. Some come without the indulgence, without the effort also. Effortlessly something comes in the mind, completely unrelated to the context. One has no idea why this thought has come up. One can't do away with that thought. So these are all possibilities which are there for everyone. So jnani's antakarana is not different anymore. He has trained his antakarana so much that there is chitta shuddhi, therefore he has more possibility to not go with the prarabdha. But the bhoga is so much in prarabdha, then it will be enforced. Circumstantially it will be enforced. Even while trying, one may not be able to come out of the situation. So people drag the, you come to this inauguration, one may have to go. One does not like to go for inauguration, but he'll have to go. One is set in an ashram where, you know, you have to lead the effort. Therefore, even if one wants to sit idle, you know, idleness is not, may become an introvert, but still one is forced to, you know, involve in festivities and ashrams, you know, expansion. It can be anything. So there are so many roles to be played based on the expectations of the society. So loka sangrahartham, all this is possible. But prarabdha vashat, the difference is prarabdha is different across jnanis, thereby all jnanis are not same, and you cannot say as to what the jnani should do. There is no rule applicable anymore, therefore antakkarana naishchalya should be there, and for that naishchalya one has to do some prayatna. That is not a rule which is applicable to a jnani, says the siddhanti to the purvapakshi. Tathapi vidusha pravrutti nivritti prarabdhadine prarabdham karma prati prani vilakshanam. It is different per prani, per person here. Now examples are what? Janaka is a quite common example, but still a rare one. Quite common in the sense, for everyone who says that, you know, one, I need not take to sannyasa, example given is Janaka. Gita Acharya also gives the example of Janaka that karma should be done loka sangrahartham. Even if you consider yourself as a jnani, says Bhagavan Krishna to Arjuna, either you are a jnani or you are an ajnani. So if you are jnani, I'll drop the a, otherwise it is confusing, ajnani versus an ajnani. So even whether you are a jnani, whether you are jnani or ajnani, you continue to do karma, says Krishna to Arjuna. It is contextual because Krishna knows there that Arjuna is not jnani. And there are various reasons also. Let's not look into that. But he tells, for you, karma is necessary. And Arjuna is overwhelmed by his grief, shokamoha. He is deluded. Therefore, Krishna says, you look at Janaka Ityadi and see how they continue to do their dharma, varnashrama dharma. Even if Janaka was a jnani, he continued to do that, loka sangrahartam. You also do that if you are jnani. If you are an ajnani, for chitta shuddhi, you have to anyway continue to do that. Otherwise, sannyasastu mahabaho dukkham aptum ayogataha. So for chitta shuddhi, jnana yogyata, you have to do karma yoga. If you are jnani, then you do it for loka sangraha. Janakadeeriva keshanchid vidusham prarabdham bhogahetur bhavati. Janaka had prarabdha that there was raja bhoga. So there are people who get married later. Even if they want to be continuing in sadhana and they don't want to marry, the marriage is a prabala prarabdha. Because another person's life is associated with yours. If you want to run away also, the other life is associated. That cannot be completed. So this person will be dragged there. Similar to this, Raja becoming a Raja, look at the kind of sadhana that somebody would have done. Karma that one has to be doing to become a king or an emperor of the order of Janaka. And not only be a king who was just a king, just another king. He has survived in history. Of course, there are multiple Janakas, they say. It is not the same Janaka. It is also said that the same Janaka was reborn. So this Janaka who did not take to sannyas was reborn as Mother Sita's father. So there are these discussions, but then we know of one Janaka who was a jnani and continued as a king, to serve as a king. Raja Bhoga was there, it was Prabala, therefore Prarabdham Bhoga Hetur Bhavati. Keshanchit Vidushan. Yasya Prarabdham Bhoga Hetuhu, Tasya Prarabdha Karma Vashad Bhoga Ichha Bhoga Sadhana Sampadane Prayatnascha Jayate. Whatever is forcing, whichever karma is forcing this jnani to continue in that ashrama for that bhoga, he will also indulge in the bhoga sadhana, because bhoga will not come of its own unless the sharira acts. So sharira will have to act, thereby antakrana vritti should be there to act. Thereby such ragadveshas will also come up in the antakrana, whereby the bhoga which is due for that particular sharira in that particular time, that will result. Thereby such ragadveshas also will come up in the antakarana. To make the person work towards something or take away something so that such bhoga is attained. Gahana karmano gati. So we don't know how it works, but then sadhu is explaining that this is how it is taking place. Because kavi, krantadarshi, they know how these work, because of it's yogi pratyaksha. It is not easy to see, it is not easy to understand also, but we get some ideas by broad strokes. Shuka vama devadinam iva keshanchid vidushan prarabdham nivrutti hetur bhavati. For others, what happens? Other jnanis like Shuka, Vamadeva. In Garbha itself, they may get jnana. Not jnana, but the prarabdha bhoga which was blocking the nishtha and thereby mukti, that may go in the process of that gestation itself. So being born in a particular womb, that prarabdha itself may take away the obstacles to jnana becoming sthira. Thereby Shukadeva was, you know, he refused to come out of the garbha. And as soon as he came out, he ran away. He was not interested in bhoga anymore. So the earlier Shravana starts working, earlier Janma Shravana starts working, and then it fructifies now. Yasya prarabdham nivrutti hetuhu tasya jivan muktyananda ichha bhogantare vaimanasyam chaudeti. So what happens there? Jivan muktyananda ichha bhogantare vaimanasyam. One is not interested in ananda through any other vishaya. No other bhoga is attractive compared to the jivan mukti ananda, which is swarupananda. So one says, I don't need to go out and bring this ananda. I don't need to manifest this ananda through any vishaya. Therefore, I will remain in samadhi, or I will not involve with anyone. I don't want any society for this ananda. One withdraws. Jivan mukti ananda, and that also is through the antakarana vritti. Antakarana will become more and more introvert. Jivan mukti ananda kangshi satatam brahmakara vrittyavruti nimittam vedantartha chintanam eva kuryatna upasanam. But even in the case of the latter, who is interested in nivritti marga, what should he do? He should not do any upasana which is prescribed in the shastra for another loka prapti. It is all for loka prapti. This person has not only vairagya towards putra and vitta iha loke, but he does not have any bhogantar ichha in another loka also. Anya loke api ichha nasti. Anya loka bhogeshu api ichha nasti. Therefore, what should he do? The Pura Pakshi is saying he should do upasana. No, he should not do upasana, because upasana will lead to anya loka. He is not interested in anya loka at all. So what should he do? He has putra vitta lokeshana traya vairagya. He does not have any of these three, bhoga, bhogechha, and to any of these three. Therefore, upasanam na kuryat, vedantartha chintanam eva kuryat. Whatever shravana he has done, he should do chintana on that. And then, satatam brahmakara vrutya vrutti nimittam. What will it lead to? This vedantartha chintana will become the nimitta for avrutti. Avrutti of what? Of brahmakara vrutti. Continuously, there will be brahmakara vrutti. That is the dhyana there. The dhyana is not as prescribed by the shastra, but he is doing dhyana on brahmakara itself. Brahma itself. He is doing dhyana on Mahavakya really, where there are two things and they become one in cognition, in understanding. And once they become one, it is not an object anymore, because aham was one part, Brahma was the other part. That aham and Brahma have been known to be one, which is aham. Therefore, the object resolves into the subject himself. Who is not a subject at all? Who is a sakshi? Who is not a sakshi at all? Because there is no sakshya separate. Therefore, it is the very swarupa. and that is the brahmakara vritti which will resolve into oneself. He practices this again and again. That is the avritti there. So it is repeated and then upasana is not needed. Nahi antakkarana naishchalya matrena brahmanandasya vishesha rupena bhanam bhavati. Why so? Because the Purva Pakshi talking about Brahmananda, Swarupananda, Jivan Muktiananda is going to be possible only when Chitta Chanchalya isn't there. That itself is not sufficient, says the Siddhanti. Just because Antakkarana is Nishchala, does it give Brahmananda? It doesn't give Brahmananda. It gives you the relief from the craving towards the Vishaya. Thereby there is Swarupananda which is manifest, which is Moda Rupa. Priya Moda and then Pramoda Rupa. But it is not that Swarupananda complete. Because there is gradation. That gradation will be there when Vishayas are varied, the desires are varied, there are gradations in Vishayas and cravings towards those Vishayas or disgust towards the Vishayas, and based on the result, the gradation of Ananda manifest will also vary in the Antakkarana. However, just because the Antakkarana is Nishchala, it does not give you Brahmananda. Vishesha Rupena Brahmanandasya Bhanam Na Bhavati. Antakkarana Naishchalya Matrena. What else is needed? Kintu Brahmakara Vrittya Eva Bhavati. Brahmakara Vritti leads to Brahmananda, not Antakkarana Naishchalyam. Sacha Brahmakara Vritti Satatam Vedantartha Chintanena Eva Jayate. Upasana does not lead to Brahmakara Vritti. What leads to Brahmakara Vritti is resolution of this Dvaita Prapancha from yourself. Ishvara separate from yourself, and that can take place only with Mahavakya Vichara. Therefore, Vedantartha Chintanam Eva Karanam Brahmanandasya. Because Brahmakara Vrittehe Karanam Tadeva. So, Chintana is going to lead to Brahmananda and not the, because Brahmananda is due to Brahmakara Vritti. Brahmakara Vritti, the argument is that Antakkarana Naishchalya will lead to Brahmananda. But the Siddhanti says you are forgetting one step preceding this. Brahmakara Vritti should come up for Brahmananda. Can Brahmakara Vritti come up by Antakkarana Naishchalya? No. Yes, Ananda is there. And Antakkarana Naishchalya leads to Ananda, but it is not Brahmananda. It is that Ananda which has gradation based on what was preceding this Naishchalya. Is this Naishchalya due to something or not? If it is due to Vishaya Raga, then based on the Vishaya Raga's level, this Vishayananda will fructify. If it was due to Vishaya Dvesha, then based on the Dvesha towards the Vishaya, there will be Ananda. This is all Priya Moda Pramoda Vritti. Graded manifestation of Swarupananda, but not Swarupananda. Vishesha Rupena Bhanam is not possible. That Vaishishtyam there is Swarupa complete. To a large measure rather. But if the Puropakshi insists that Upasana is going to lead to Brahmananda, it is not that Vishaya Raga or Vishaya Dvesha. The Upasana Vishaya is still there. If you say it is not Vishaya the way Laukika Vishaya is talked about, it is not that Laukika Vishaya, but Upasana is based on some Devata Vishesha. That Devata Vishesha is a Vishaya, it is an object. A particular form or particular Shabda, what are you doing Upasana on? That Upasana Vishaya is still there. Therefore, gradation is there even there. If gradation is there, then that will also lead to only that kind of Vishayananda. It is not Brahmananda proper. एंड इवन इफ दैट विषय आनंद और उपासना उपासना जन्य आनंद और उपासना लीडिंग टू समाधि एंड दैट समाधि जन्य आनंद इज ऑल्सो ब्रह्मानंद मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ द सेम स्वरूप ब्रह्मात्मा आनंद स्टिल इट इज नॉट कंप्लीट ब्रह्मानंद वाई बिकॉज ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति इज इन देयर It is going to be troubling. Even if you say it is Brahmananda, that will not take away your obstacles to remaining in that Jivan Mukti avastha, so to say, avastha for a lack of better word, meaning not coming out to bandha again, not coming out to bandha from that samadhi again. That is possible only when Brahmakara Vritti is leading to that Ananda. And that Brahmakara Vritti is not going to be a resultant of Antakarana Naishchalya, whether it is due to Upasana or anything else. Vidushaha Antakarana Chanchalyam api Vedantartha Chintanene Vaduri Bhavati. So Antakarana Chanchalya will go away for the Vidwan also, not through Upasana. Although it is possible, but he is looking for Brahmananda, which is possible due to Brahmakara Vritti, for which there is only one sadhana, Vedantartha Chintana. Atascha Vidusha Antakkarana Naishchalya Sampadanaya Na Upasane Pravrittir Jayate. So he has no interest that pops up in his Antakkarana, oh let me do Upasana, because I was a great Upasaka earlier, that thought does not need to continue, it may not continue. तथा यस्य दृढ़बोध संजातः तस्य कर्मोपासनयो प्रवृत्तिर् न भवति सो दृढ़बोध यस्य संजातः व्हेन दिस संशय रहित ज्ञान इज बोर्न देन दैट पर्सन डज नॉट हैव प्रवृत्ति टुवर्ड्स कर्म और उपासना ज्ञानी हैज टू कंटिन्यू हिज Chitta Naishchalya, if that is the argument, then yes, we agree for Jivan Mukti Ananda, this Chitta Naishchalya is needed, but it is not due to Upasana, it is due to Vedantartha Shravana Manana Nididhyasana itself. Nothing else, that Nididhyasana is Dhyana, but it is not the Dhyana as prescribed by the Shastra, called as Upasana. So Upasana is dropped, Nishtha is practiced, Nishtha is brought about by Nitaram Sthiti, that Nitaram Sthiti is brought about by Nididhyasana, which is a follow-on from Manana. So, Vedantartha Chintana. Dridajnaninam, Adridajnaninam, Uttama Jidnyasunancha Karmopasanayor Anadhikaraha. Moreover, there is no adhikara at all for a jnani in karma and upasana. Even if the jnani does karma and upasana, he is not a karta. Then what phala will he get? If he is not going to get any phala, why would he do it? Now this is true not only for a dhrida jnani, for a adhrida jnani also. Meaning for one who has samshaya, for him also, it is needed. If you call him as not samshaya, but here samshaya rahita, but asthira, there is lot of viparita bhavana. So since jnani has been mentioned there, we take drada jnani as one who has jnana where samshayas don't come up. But what kind of samshayas? It is not that doubt that whether it is true, but then he cannot stay with that for a longer duration because the earlier bhavana comes back again, which is viparita to what Vedanta teaches. So I know that I am limitless. I know that I am Brahma. I don't have any doubts that I am Brahma. But what happens is that I forget this when there is circumstantially something else. Forget this in a sense, jnana need not be remembered. But initially the training, the mind, because it is all in the antakkarna, when the raga and dvesha are overpowering, because there is a bhavana that I am a person. Jnani does not forget that he is a man or a woman, he or she, is a man or a woman, does not forget that one belongs to a particular ashrama or a varna, so that idea will still be there. Although one does not consider oneself as so, I mean, it is not that he'll start eating stones because everything is one. He'll still eat the same thing. He'll put the food in the same mouth. So there is no difference there. And there need not be any difference there. This samatha bhava does not mean that he starts eating anything and everything. So the idea which was there earlier, which has trained the antakarana, will continue, and that continuing viparita bhavana can come up. Viparita bhavana is viparita to what? It is opposed. Opposed to what? Viparita or contrary to. Contrary to what Vedanta is saying, Upanishad is saying, that you are Brahma. So I am Brahma, but at the same time I am a Brahma who is a human being, a man or a woman, a child or a grown up or an elder or a young person. All these ideas are also there. These are contrary to Brahma, because Brahma does not have a gender, does not have varna ashrama, does not have age. But still Brahma is not going to be hungry, but I am hungry. Jnani will be hungry. Based on, of course, the prarabdha, the vrittis will be different. It can be pravritti or nivritti, and then follow on antakarana vrittis will also be different. But karma upasana adhikara isn't there. And this is true even for a uttama jijnyasu, who is not a jnani yet, who is a vedita michu jijnyasu, jnatu michu. They themselves lose adhikara in karma and upasana, then why would they practice karma or upasana? Mandabodhavan, uttama jijnyasurapi. So one who has some idea that Shastra talks about this Vishaya, Brahma, how I don't know, but then there is this Tattvamasi Mahavakya. So Mandabodha is there. But uttama jijnyasu is completely interested in only jnana. So for him, what happens? This mandabodhavan uttama jijnyasurapi karma upasanayor na pravartate. He does not have pravritti in karma and upasana. Why? Because he is a jijnyasu. Yasya tu mandabodha asti sa manana nidhyasane eva kuryat. Shravana is taking place, he knows. He gets some idea, but then samshaya is still there. Therefore, he should continue to inquire into whatever shravana he is doing, and continue shravana also. Shravana punah punah kuryat, and then manana also, followed by nididhyasana later. Tena karma upasane na kartavye. Karma and upasana need the person to be karta, whereas this fellow has mandabodha of I am not a karta. This akarta, if he takes himself as a karma karta or upasana karta, they are contradictory. How can he become a jnani? How can one become jnani when one takes oneself as karta and then says that Upanishad tells me that I am not a karta? This akarta, who has mandabodha of akartrutvam, if he keeps on doing karma upasana, what will happen? That mandabodha will also go away. So they are opposed. Adhikara itself isn't there, because he is trying to deepen his understanding of akartrutvam. He cannot be doing karma where kartrutvam is enforced. Upasana, there also this kartrutvam is enforced. Bheda is enforced, karaka bheda. Phala is talked about, which is what he is not interesting to him at all. He does not want karma phala, he does not want upasana phala. He wants only jnana. Then what should he do? He should drop all this. There is no adhikara itself. Yasya mandabodha asti sa uttama jijnyasu. So he should have this understanding of whatever is gathered in Shravana, some understanding should be there, although doubts are to be resolved. So for doubts to be resolved, he should step out of the karma upasana and inquire into the fact as taught by the Shastra and Acharya. Tasya manana nidhyasane vina kartavyantaram nasti. So yamartha sharirake sutrakara sutrakarehi bhashyakarehi pratipaditah. In Brahma Sutra 4.10.2, there is this discussion on whether the Jijnyasu should continue to do karma upasana or not, or should take to Vividisha Sannyasa. And there, the Sutrakara, Bhagavan Vyasa as well as Bhagavan Bhashyakara say that he has no other kartavyattvam. And what does that mean? Oh, he need not take sannyasa. If this is the argument, true. But then what has been said? Kartavyantaram nasti karma upasane adhikaraha nasti. What does it mean? He cannot remain in the ashrama and continue to do whatever he likes, meaning jijnyasa, by giving up his karma. So he has to continue to do karma. But if he has no adhikara and he is not going to get phala, why would he do karma? Thereby, he cannot stay in the ashrama and drop the karma. So he has to drop the ashrama instead. This is a better way. But then obviously, we have seen that prarabdha can be prabala. So vidushatu mananidhyasani api chodanaya kartavyatva buddhya na anushtheye. So vidwan also does not have this rule to follow. Shastra says karma and upasana should be done. So that is the chodana there. Chudi prerane. So prerana is given by Shastra that you do karma, you do upasana in this manner. So that is also not applicable to vidwan. It is not applicable to vidwan also. It is not applicable to jijnyasu itself. Then how can it be applicable to vidwan? Kintu jivan mukti anandaya manan nidhyasana yor vidwan pravartate. Now karma upasana, we have seen that there is no vidhi for ajnani. But manan nidhyasana is been talked with tavya pratyaya. Atma vare drashtavya shrotavyo mantavyo nididhyasitavya. So drashtavya tavya pratyaya is there. How? Shrotavya. Shravana is over at the stage of a jijnyasu. Then as vidwan or a one who is mandabodhavan, there itself shravana stage is over, then manana is being done. Shravana stage is over means shravana can be continued and should be continued because it will be the basis for manana. But when he is doing manana and nididhyasana as prescribed by the Shastra, mantavyaha says that tavya pratyaya shows kartavyataya, kartavyatva buddhi should be there. But here vidushatu manana nidhyasana api chodanaya kartavyatva buddhya na anushteye. For a mandabodhavan, manana and nididhyasana is kartavya. Therefore mantavya nididhyasitavya. But one who is a vidwan, for him manana nidhyasana is also not applicable. So he should take to Nivritti Marga is also not valid. So there is no instruction possible. There is no vidhi possible for a jnani, for a vidwan. Kintu jivan mukti anandaya manana nidhyasana yor vidwan pravartate. Then why would one do manana nidhyasana if it is not prescribed by the Shastra? It is prescribed by the Shastra for avidwan. Jijnyasu, so he should continue. But once he becomes vidwan, then manana and nididhyasana are also not applicable anymore. Because Shruti is invalidated by the jnana, because there is no second. Whatever Shruti had as its purpose, that goal he has met. Then why would he do anything or not do anything? There is no rule applicable. But still, jivan mukti ananda is needed. And if he needs Jivan Mukti Ananda, then he should do Manana Nididhyasana. Not as a rule, but he would do. There the Shakyarthe that ling will have tavya will have the shakyartha like vidhiling. Vidhiling is not vidhi alone. Vidhi nimantrana amantrana abhishta samprashna prarthana. So all the samprashna prarthana, all these meanings are applicable. Shakyarthe ling is also possible. So that is applicable to tavya also. And lot also. So vidhiling, lot and tavyas have the same meaning. It can be shakyartha also. So he would do. Possibly, what will he do? As long as prarabdha is there, sharira is going to be there, he does not want to indulge and taint his antakkarana. He cares for the antakkarana also. He need not care for the antakkarana because he is not the antakkarana. But let's say the vrittis come up which he does not need. They are not meaningful to him. So what he may do is for jivan mukti ananda, because finally the indulgence has been for ananda, the search has been for ananda. There is nothing wrong in the jnani wanting this ananda, and he does not want the vishaya ananda, which is nishiddha because it is trapping. Therefore he gives up the vishayas and continues in manana nididhyasana. He would do that for jivan mukti ananda. साच प्रवृत्तिर विदुषः स्वेच्छया एव न चोदनया. इट इज नॉट बाय श्रुति टेलिंग यू दैट फॉर जीवन मुक्त्यानंदा यू हैव टू डू दिस, यू डू दिस. ही ऑलरेडी हैज अनुभव दैट मनन निधिध्यासन हैज लेड टू दिस आनंद. ही जस्ट नोज बाय अनुभव ही कंटिन्यूज टू डू दैट. देर इज नो प्रिस्क्रिप्शन. इट इज दैट तव्य इज नो लॉन्गर हैविंग दी vidhi meaning. Mantavya nididhyasitavya does not have the vidhi meaning anymore. Thereby he picks by his own choice. Yadyaham vedajnya rupam karma na kuryam tadame janana maranadi rupa samsaro bhavetiti buddhya kriyamanam eva karma kartavyam ityuchyate. What is this kartavyatva buddhi in the shastra's vidhis? It becomes a vidhi only when, if I don't do that, it will lead me to samsara, which is in the form of janma and marana. That is the thinking. That idea leading to doing karma, upasana, or in this case manana or nididhyasana, is what is said as kartavyam. However, he does not consider it as kartavyam because he picks by his own choice, not by thinking that if I don't do it, I will become a samsari again or continue to be a samsari. He knows that he is already a mukta, but he prefers this ananda, jivan mukti ananda. Saiyam janmadi vishayini buddhir vidusho na bhavati tasmat svechaya eva vidvan manana nidhyasane karoti ataste manana nidhyasane kartavye iti vyapadesha anarhe. So they ought not to be called as kartavye. Manana and nididhyasana are being done by the jnani by choice, by swaichha, and prarabdha vashat also, but has nothing to do with the shruti telling one to do. Evancha yasya mandabodho va dridabodho va sanjataha tasya karma upasane kartavye na bhavataha. Therefore the Purvapakshi is saying the karma and upasana should be done, or he says you are doing manana and nididhyasana, if that is kartavya, then why not do the karma and upasana as kartavya? So Siddhanti says not only karma upasana are not kartavya, but even the manana nididhyasana are not kartavya for a vidwan. Manana nididhyasana are kartavya for a jidnyasu, but karma upasana are not kartavya for a jidnyasu even. So that is the uttara for that akshepa. We'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishtanam buddhya buddhyam buddher drukyatu nirmalam aparam sravedanta vidyam pratyak paramha tadevahannamattu nirthi minishchitamutihi. Namaste.